One of the seven Republicans who voted to convict Trump, Senator Bill Cassidy of Louisiana. Dr. Cassidy, thanks for joining us this morning. You had a pretty succinct statement in the wake of your vote. You say, I voted to convict President Trump because he is guilty. Why do you think he's guilty? When did you make up your mind?
So I listened very carefully to all the arguments. But if you describe insurrection as I did, as an attempt to prevent the peaceful transfer of power, we can see the president for 2 months after the election promoting that the election was stolen. People still tell me they think that Minion rigged those machines with Hugo Chavez from Venezuela. That is not true. And all the news organizations that promoted that have retracted. He then scheduled the rally for January the 6th, just when the transfer of power was to take place. And he brought together a crowd, but a portion of that was transformed into a mob. And when they went into the Capitol, it was clear that he wished that lawmakers be intimidated. And even after he knew there was violence taking place, he continued to basically sanction the mob being there. And not until later did he actually ask them to leave. All of that points to a motive and a method, and that is wrong. He should be held accountable.
You are already facing backlash in your home state, as I know you know. The executive committee of the Louisiana GOP voted unanimously to censure you last night. And the chair of the Republican caucus in the Louisiana State House added this. We want to show it right now. Senator Bill Cassidy, you no longer represent the majority of people in Louisiana who recently voted you into office. You are part of the problem with D.C. Don't expect a warm welcome when you come home to Louisiana. Your response?
I have the privilege of having the facts before me and being able to spend several days deeply going into those facts. As these facts become more and more out there, if you will, and folks have a chance to look for themselves, more folks will move to where I was. People want to trust. They want to trust their leaders. They want people to be held accountable. Now, I'm attempting to hold President Trump accountable. And that is the trust I have from the people that elected me. And I am very confident that as time passes, people will move to that position.
So you think you'll eventually represent a majority of you in Louisiana?
You know, number one, I think I may already represent a majority of you. Don't allow one person's statement to reflect the entirety of the majority of the people in Louisiana, number one. And number two, I was elected to uphold an oath to support and defend the Constitution. The majority of the people in Louisiana want that to be the case. And I have respected that trust. I have voted to support and defend the Constitution.
You probably saw that statement from former President Trump yesterday. He said his political movement has only just begun. Do you think he can run a credible campaign for president again? Will he remain a force in the Republican Party? What does that mean for the Republican Party?
I think his force wanes. The Republican Party is more than just one person. The Republican Party is about ideas. We were the party that was founded to end slavery. We were the party that preserved the Union. We were the party that passed the first civil rights law. We were the party that ended the Cold War. We are the party that before COVID had an economy that had record low unemployment for everyone that is able, the high school dropout, the veteran, the woman, the black, the Hispanic, you name it. That is the party of ideas. Now the American people want those ideas, but they want a leader who is accountable and a leader who they can trust. I think our leadership will be different going forward, but it will still be with those ideas.
One of the questions on accountability is, should the president face some kind of criminal accountability? You saw both your colleague Tom Tillis of North Carolina, even the leader McConnell, suggesting that that was possible. Do you think criminal charges should be pursued against former President Trump?
I'm a gastroenterologist, not an attorney. I will leave that question to others. I think more importantly is, how do we move forward from this? If you will, criminal trials will be looking back. We need to look forward because the ideas of our party are more important now than ever, particularly in contrast to the Biden-Harris administration, which with a stroke of a pen ended 11,000 jobs on Keystone XL pipeline. And by the way, with that, will increase global greenhouse gas emissions. If there's ever a time for a party to point out, wait, we make the environment worse, but we lose 11,000 jobs, now is the time. And that should be where our party goes.
So you want to look forward. Does that mean no 9/11 style commission, as the former chairs of the 9/11 commission, Thomas Kane and Lee Hamilton, have called for?
You know, I don't. I think there should be a complete investigation about what happened on 1/6. Both why was there not more law enforcement, National Guard already mobilized, what was known, who knew it, and when they knew it, all that, because that builds the basis so this never happens again in the future. I think that is also important, George, but that is different from allowing that to define the future of the Republican Party.
Dr. Cassidy, thanks for your time this morning.
Thank you.
We are now joined by...